Many ages ago, this land was inhabited by an ancient people called the Salish. Their lore masters tell a tale of a young brave named Belagwa, or in modern tongue, Pilchuck. And one day, while out hunting, he was visited by a spirit in the form of an eagle.
"Listen to me, young brave,"
it said to him.
"A great evil is coming, and it destroys all. Lands, beasts, and even you, my children. Follow me to this peak, and I will show you."
Today, I'll be following young Belagwa's footsteps, at least part of the way. I'll be traveling the highly popular trail to Lake 22 on the side of Mount Pilchuck. It seems to me that there's different feelings in different forests. Young forests have a vibrant and energetic feeling. Older forests have a feeling of age, history, and wisdom. Or maybe it's just me.
"Look about you. Don't all these trees have names and voices of their own?"
It's a 2.5 mile trip up to the lake, and most of your elevation is gained in the second half of the trail. So pace yourself in the first half, because when you get to the second half is when you start gaining most of that altitude.
"And every bush and stone laid with purpose by the Great One."
And take a look here. We have some wild blueberries. Real popular snacks for birds and bears and even people.
"And not a tree falls without our knowledge." "And the great trees would not stand without the dirt beneath them. And the rivers, though they cleave stone, do not their waters nourish all life? And we take delight in their songs? Yes, all things are connected."
Soon the trail starts scrambling out in this open area here, and over a boulder field. The lake lies up in that little nook behind that mound there.
About two-thirds of the way up, you leave the forest and enter a boulder field. On sunny days, be prepared to shield yourself from the sun.
And in that hour, the eagle and Belagwa heard evil things coming up behind him. The eagle cried out in a great voice, and lightning smote the side of the mountain and caused a great rent, and stones and trees and a matter of things flowed down and crushed the path behind them, and left a great chasm in the side of the mountain.
Once you pass that boulder field, you're back into the forest for a bit and out of the direct exposure. The trail here is pretty nice. I mean, it's not mild by any means, but it's well maintained, well marked.
It never ceases to amaze me how trees can just seem to grow just about anywhere, even on top of old dead trees.
I guess it's better than just leaving your dog's crap right on the trail. Maybe. Lake 22. And in the background there, you see Mount Pilchuck.
"Make haste! The peak is near!"
said the eagle.
There's a trail and a boardwalk that make a loop all the way around the lake during the summer months anyway. And there are many, many spots here to stop and have a little picnic and hang out.
And they reached the peak, and from there they descried the shadow. And it moved across the land and devoured all, and even the village of Belagwa. And there on the peak he loosed his tears, and so also did the eagle spirit, and even the god of sun. And their tears flowed down the mountains in great rivulets and falls, and filled the great chasm. And the air was filled with the sound of their cries and their tears. The great chasm filled, as if a lake. And the sun god hollowed it and said, "Here, even in great sorrow, will things come anew and life again. In the shimmering waters, growth, hope is born. And though the cold winters will feel my wrath, so also the spring bring new and life and growth." And Belagwa drew his blade and raised it towards the heavens. Life left him and his spirit entered into it. And the sun said, "Look here at each one of these peaks. Each one is the soul of a guardian, watching, ever vigilant lest evil come again."
Everyone, that wraps up episode 7 here at Lake 22 on Mount Pilchuck. I hope you've enjoyed it. Remember, please leave a thumbs up, subscribe, and until the next time, have a good one. And if you're local to Western Washington, feel free to leave an idea for me to go do next. I just might check it out.